Such a lovely young lady. And that's the thing, that kids of all ages are being treated here, and kids of all ages are miracles because of the awesome treatment that they're getting in this hospital. And I had the opportunity to meet one spunky little girl, Emma Stroud from Seelands Grove. She has this amazing personality, and you'd never know by hanging out with her that her life didn't start out so great. Here's Emma's story.
On any given day, 6-year-old Emma Stroud from Seelands Grove can be found playing with dolls. And dinosaurs. Her imagination has no boundaries, and she has a personality to match.
Hey, I think I should wear a big boob.
Parents Jennifer and Joe beam with pride seeing their spunky sweetheart play like this. Because there was a time in Emma's young life when they thought this day might never happen. Emma was delivered via cesarean section at Geisinger Janet Weis Children's Hospital in Danville at 37 weeks because she had stopped growing.
And when she was born, she was very tiny. She was only 3 pounds, 13 ounces, but she was not considered a preemie. But because she was so small, they took her to the NICU.
A few hours later, doctors from the neonatal intensive care unit revealed some devastating news.
And that's when they said that they realized they tried to put a feeding tube down Emma's throat and it stopped in a pouch. It got stuck.
You're told, you know, your perfect baby, your perfect child can't swallow.
Geisinger pediatric gastroenterologist Dr. Marty Maximak explains Emma's issue.
She was born with esophageal atresia T fistula. It means that her esophagus was not connected from her mouth to her stomach. And then she also had an abnormal connection from her esophagus to her lungs.
And to hear that, you know, you can't picture your future. I mean, or if you do picture your future, all these horrible scenarios run through your head.
Not only did Emma need surgery to fix her esophagus, she had another problem that required immediate attention. Geisinger pediatric cardiologist Dr. David Connick said an echocardiogram, funded through generous donations to Children's Miracle Network, revealed a cardiac abnormality called coarctation of the aorta, or narrowing of the large blood vessel leading from the heart, a potentially lethal condition.
In Emma's case, the coarctation, or the narrowing of the aorta, was very severe, and she was only getting blood through that area because she had something called a ductus arteriosus, which is a channel that has to be present in the fetus for normal circulation and cardiac development, but usually closes in the first week or so after life.
Emma needed surgery right away.
At the time that she was born, we didn't have a cardiac surgeon here at Janet Weis. And because of that, she went to Nemours, which is one of our partner hospitals.
At just one day old, Emma was flown to Wilmington, Delaware.
I remember being back in the hospital room after seeing her hooked to many, many wires. This teeny tiny little baby and the flight team packing her up. And I remember being back in the room, and I remember hearing the helicopter take off and just thinking, there goes my baby, and I'm not with her.
Recovering from a C-section, Jen wasn't initially able to follow her daughter. Joe drove down to be at his baby's side.
Not knowing what this meant, not knowing what to do, I mean, even supporting my wife, you know, how best to tell her everything was gonna be okay when I didn't know if everything was gonna be okay.
At 3 days old, Emma had her heart surgery. 10 days after that, she had her esophagus repaired. 3 weeks later, she was finally strong enough to fly back to Geisinger Janet Weis Children's Hospital in Danville, where she spent another week in the pediatric intensive care unit. It wasn't until just before Thanksgiving when Emma was able to come home for the first time. But 3 days before Christmas, there was another unexpected setback.
That was when I was sitting on this couch right here, feeding her, and that's when she had her first cyanotic episode, her first blue spell.
Where she would bring up all her formula and it would cut off her airways and she would go blue and become unresponsive.
That was the scariest moment of my life.
Emma spent her first Christmas in the hospital, where she was diagnosed with having severe acid reflux and put on Prevacid. She was able to return home later that day. But within the first 2 years of her life, Emma would go on to have 4 more similar episodes.
It's very draining. physically draining, emotionally draining, mentally draining.
Emma also had an enlarged iris in her right eye. At 3 months old, she had eye patch therapy and got glasses for her farsightedness, an accessory that's become her signature. And just when the Straubs thought her hospital stays were over, it was discovered Emma had congenital hip dysplasia that, at 9 months of age, needed to be surgically repaired. She spent 4 months in a full body cast and had to be fitted for a helmet to reshape her head as a result of laying flat in the cast.
He just kind of went with the punches and just took everything one day at a time, and she stayed so happy through all of it.
And that happiness continues to this day as Emma is thriving.
Emma was born with a severe, potentially lethal cardiac defect, and now she's a bright, happy, healthy, sociable, wonderful little girl who has a really bright future.
I mean, even without any medical problems, you can see that she's a wonderful little girl who's very outgoing.
Even though her esophagus and heart condition are lifelong concerns, Emma isn't letting that slow her down.
Energetic, outgoing, smart, funny, beautiful. I mean, I'm her dad, so I'm a little biased, but I think anybody who meets her can at least see some of those qualities, if not all of them.
Because this is the hardest yet I ever had. Thanks. You say what you want to say, and let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you be brave. What you want to say, and let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you be brave. I just want to see you. I just want to see you. I just want to see you. I want to see you be brave. I just want to see you. I just want to see you.
Oh, there she is. How about a round of applause for little Miss Emma Straub? We are so glad that she is here today. You guys, she went through so much in just her first few days of life, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
And look at her now.
If it would have been so nice, we always say this, that if we could have seen a little bit into the future how awesome she is, it would have made things a little easier. But, you know, but she's quite the fighter.
She is. And oh, I love her little personality. You guys have done a great job raising her because she is such a little sparkler. Now, Dad, you were talking a little bit about, I know you said you're biased. She is everything that you said she is. Yeah. It was a challenging first year of life, a couple years, wasn't it?
First 2 years, yes, very challenging. I mean, for us, being new parents, this is our one and only child, and not knowing what to expect, not knowing where to go, not knowing, you know, decisions that we were making, are they the right ones? But it was so wonderful having Geisinger here to help put our minds at ease and take care of things for us.
Let's talk about that a little bit. The staff here is amazing, and the care is top-notch. Yeah. What do you have to say about the kind of treatment you received as parents when you were going through this? Because it was obviously very scary.
Right. Oh, it was wonderful treatment. Everybody here, so nice. Her specialty doctors are great. Just that you can tell that they really care about your child, you know, just by the way they interact with them. And it's wonderful.
All right. Let me talk to Dr. Connick for a second here. I imagine working on a child so small, there were some challenges there.
She was tiny, and she was incredibly sick, not just with one thing, but with multiple problems. And because of that, the risk of complications was very high. And she had complications. She had the reflux. She had the blue spells. But heart-wise, the risk is that she would get re-narrowing of the aorta, where it was narrowed, the coarctation. Mm-hmm. And that's something we kind of expected in the first few years of life because she was so small. And even with that expectation, so far she's done great. She's been healthy heart-wise. She's done really well. She's not had further problems. And we're hoping that she just stays like this long-term. So she's certainly posed some challenges because she was so small, but she's done great. And this is our reward, seeing her like this, seeing someone who's wonderful like this, And hopefully when she gets a little older, I can get her out to Camp Victory also, to Camp Echo, because she'll be wonderful there. So I just am thrilled that she's done this well.
I mean, you see firsthand the miracles and the amazing things at your hands as a doctor. But when you see little girls and little boys like Emma thrive after going through some things, some medical challenges, how does that make you feel as a doctor?
It's what makes it worth it. Yeah. You see a child who's incredibly ill. If they didn't have multiple things done, they wouldn't survive. And then you see them grow up, and you see this is the reward. Seeing her long-term, seeing her year after year do well. She just graduated kindergarten. Yes. I can't believe that. You're a graduate, Emma.
Well, let's here real quickly. Let me talk to you, Emma, because, of course, you're the little star. So how was school?
Good.
And how was graduation?
Really good.
Yeah. I've heard in the buzz is that you sang a song at graduation.
Yep.
Can I hear it?
Mm-hmm. Kindergarten had me a blast. Kindergarten went by so fast. Made some friends, cute as can be. Had a teacher crazy for me. Kindergarten went by so fast, but now it's time to go.
Aw, awesome. Great job, sweetheart. All right, folks. Yes, take a bow. Absolutely. If you know Emma's job, you're a neighbor, if you live in the Selins Grove area, if you have a child who went to school with Emma, why not pick up the phone and make that call? 1-800-322-5437. Make that donation and make more miracles happen, just like sweet little Emma Straub. Now let's check in with Eric.